It's been a great transition. You know, we started off investing in the picks and shovels, you know, in venture capital and companies that are laying the groundwork for cryptocurrencies to function better, for security tokens to emerge. And we started to have incoming inquiries from, you know, hospitals, endowments, foundations, pension funds. And we went out and looked for a world-class provider of a solution in crypto and partnered with Bitwise to create this first digital asset index fund.
Was it the custodian issue that really kept you on the sidelines for so long? I mean, you've been at this for quite some time, but not in the crypto assets specifically.
Yeah, really important point, and thanks for bringing that up. You know, we started where we felt secure, where we could own the equity of businesses. We went in to see how custody, which is the issue that people really are focused on today, would evolve. And we think there are some institutional quality custody solutions that are out there and being developed by firms like Coinbase and Northern Trust and others. So we are excited about the direction. We think we're early, and we really want to be the trusted advisor to institutions in the crypto world.
To be expected, I mean, your portfolio, if we can show what your allocation is, about 69% Bitcoin, 15% Ethereum, 5.5% Bitcoin Cash. It sort of traces the market caps of each individual coin.
Yes.
Of note, though, you have excluded XRP and you've excluded Stellar, and that's for specific reasons. You don't want to own pre-mined coins. You don't want to own pre-mined coins in which a big proportion of the coins are owned by one party. Why is that? Is that fear of manipulation?
No, really, it's about risk management, right? Institutions don't care so much about big returns. They want to manage risk. You know, Howard Marks, who's been a friend and mentor for 25 years, has this great line. If you want to be in the top 5% of all funds, like all the crypto hedge funds last year, you have to take an inordinate amount of risk and you could end up in the bottom 5%. Blockchain technology is a revolutionary technology. It's akin to the internet or the Android and iOS operating systems for mobile phones. This is the next big platform, and we're going to create something called the TrustNet, and it will allow transactions of value to occur without a trusted intermediary, without a rent-seeking middleman. And so all the big financial institutions, of course they don't like it because it has the ability to replace them. We don't need, if I want to transfer money to you, we don't need a bank to take a cut of that. We can do it on the blockchain, openly and public, secure. The Bitcoin blockchain has never had one issue of fraud, not one. How many times have you or I had to change our Visa or MasterCard number because of fraud? It is the most secure network on the planet. It is the largest computer network on the planet, 7,500 times more powerful than the next most powerful supercomputer.
And Mark, I'm curious, though, in terms of your very bullish outlook for the price of Bitcoin over the next 6 years, what in your view does the price of Bitcoin reflect right now? Does it reflect usage? Does it reflect the vibrancy of the blockchain? I'm just trying to understand how you view it in terms of how you're seeing the price fluctuation.
Yes, really, really important question. And the key is, like any asset, there's price, which is simply the level at which two previous individuals transacted or two previous institutions transacted. And then there's the value, the underlying intrinsic or inherent value. And so the value of a network is determined by the number of participants, the amount of capital that goes into that network. Think about this. Five of the largest 10 companies in the world today are networks. They're not really corporations. They don't own assets. They provide services through a network. So that's the same thing with these crypto networks. Is the network value is determined by participants, transactions, and that growth is reflected in a very complex log linear regression model, and the value we think is somewhere around $10,000 to $11,000 per unit per Bitcoin. Mm-hmm. So when the price is below that, as it is today, we think it's a buy.